I've been holding off making this video about PewDiePie and T Series because first, well, there was that inane race, and then there were potshots at each other, and then today there is a court case with an actual ruling. But like the man said, I need to go all out just this once. And also, like the man said, look at T Series, they are going crying to their momma. Let's get started. Unless you've been living under a mushroom, you're probably already aware of this T-Series versus PewDiePie thing, but here's a quick recap. PewDiePie, Swedish YouTuber, Felix Arvid, 30-year-old, makes videos, vlog videos, and let's play videos, started his channel in 2010 and hit 50 million subscribers in 2016. Remember that year, 2016. T-Series, Indian music channel, belongs to T-Series, Super Cassettes Private Limited, started in 2006 and hit 10 million subscribers in 2016. Remember that year, 2016. Now, March 31st is when this entire thing started to heat up. PewDiePie uploaded the congratulations video, overtook T-Series. Both of them are currently sitting at about 93 million subscribers. T-Series is already the most viewed channel on YouTube with 60 billion views. T-Series initially said, "This is not a competition, we don't really care," and then said, "This is a question of national pride," and finally went to court to get a legal takedown against PewDiePie's two of his more controversial videos, Congratulations and Bitch Lasagna. I'm an Indian, I've subscribed to PewDiePie, I have not subscribed to T-Series. In fact, if there was a way to get YouTube to block T-Series for me from recommending T-Series to me, I would definitely do it. I think that PewDiePie eventually will lose, but in my mind, he will always be the number one. I spoke about 2016 at the start of this video. Here are the three reasons that 2016 is important and which have a huge impact on this whole T-Series and PewDiePie battle. Firstly, in 2016, after 20 years of standing still, the global music industry actually grew to $15 billion. Obviously, this was due in large part to streaming services like Spotify and Apple Music, which grew 50% year on year, overtaking CDs. Another interesting fact here is at 2016, about 1 billion people, roughly the entire population of India, were streaming music on YouTube for free. The second thing that happened in 2016 was something that I recently posted a video about, Jio. Jio is not a Wi-Fi company, it's a mobile network operator in India, which currently has 250 million subscribers. To put that number in perspective, that is about 3/4 the entire population of the US and about 6 times the population of the UK. A research firm called Cable recently did a study and found that India has the cheapest mobile data rates in the entire world. We pay 17 rupees for a gigabyte, the UK pays 400 rupees, and the US pays 800 rupees for a gigabyte. The third thing that happened in 2016 is that India overtook the US to become the second largest smartphone market with 300 million smartphones, not mobile phones, and 83 million smartphones were made in India, resulting in cheaper prices for everyone here. So this is where we are at right now. India has 1.32 billion people. YouTube Music launched in India last month for 100 bucks a month. And YouTube is the number one streaming service in India for music. PewDiePie can't win against a music company, definitely not against an Indian music company. But in my mind, like I said, he's always going to be number one. Knowing all of this, it's incredibly frustrating and annoying to me that T-Series had to resort to legal action in order to get YouTube to take down two of PewDiePie's videos. Well done, T-Series. Well done. Congratulations. In fact, Alexa, play Congratulations by PewDiePie.
Congratulations by PewDiePie and Rumian Boy Nay Band, starting now on Amazon Music.
One more thing. Okay, Google, play Bitch Lasagna by PewDiePie.
Okay, Bitch Lasagna by PewDiePie. Playing on Google Play Music.
I don't like your T-Series. Nothing personal, kid. But I must go all out. Just this once.
Thanks for watching.